Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge and welcome back to my channel. Today, we'll take a look at how you can easily cut your videos to the music beat using Beat Mark 2 from Ultimedia. The new Beat Mark 2 plugin analyzes your song and adds markers on every beat. You can then export it as an XML file and import it into Final Cut Pro with markers placed on every beat. This video isn't sponsored, but I do have 5 free licenses for Beat Mark 2 to give away. I'll tell you how you can enter to win one of these at the end of this video. Let's open up Beat Mark 2 and get started. Grab your song you want to use and drag and drop it into Beat Mark 2. Select your frame rate you want to use for your project and open the preferences window. If your song has a consistent tempo, select the standard analysis type. If the tempo in your song changes, use peak filter. Alternately, you can select the audio peak analysis to mark the parts of your song with vocals. With your preferences set, close the preference window and hit the Beat Mark button. Beat Mark 2 analyzes your selected song, adds markers on every beat, and opens it up in a separate timeline, very similar to Final Cut Pro. There's a few more options you can adjust here. First up is the Mark First Quarter box. Zoom in on your timeline until you can see all individual markers, and scroll back to the start of your song. Press the play button to start playing your song and listen for the first beat. Once you identify the marker closest to the first beat, select the Mark First Quarter checkbox and click on the identified marker. This changes the color of every fourth marker, making it much easier to identify the start of each measure. You can also select this checkbox to suggest cuts every 4 loops, giving a different color marker for every measure. As far as exporting, you can either select to just mark beats in your asset to export your song as an XML file with markers, or you can also choose to create a new event and project. This way, when you import this XML into Final Cut Pro, it'll open up in its own separate event with your song in a new project. Selecting the Create Placeholder option will also add placeholder clips above your song cut on every beat. Let's make a new project with placeholder clips and see how easy it is to edit to the music beat in Final Cut Pro. Click Continue to export an FCPX XML file and close Beat Mark 2. You can find your exported file in the same location as your original song, which in my case is right on my desktop. Let's open up Final Cut Pro and import our new XML file. From the menu bar, select File, Import, and XML. Select your file and click Import. This may take a little bit of time because Final Cut Pro has to import your file, make a new event, and a new project with placeholder clips. Once your import is complete, you'll see a new event in your library with the same name as your song. Inside this event, you'll find your new project. Double-click it to open it up. If you zoom in on your timeline, you can see that every beat is marked with a blue marker, the start of every measure is a red marker, and every 4 measures is marked with a green marker. There's also placeholder clips connected to your timeline between every beat. For this demo, we only need about 15 seconds of music, so skim your timeline and find the closest green marker. Place your playhead on this marker, select your music clip, and press Command-B to blade it. Delete the second part of the clip, and drag the fade handle at the end to fade out the music. Next, let's replace our placeholder clips with our own. Grab your first clip and drag it down into your timeline over the placeholder clip until it's highlighted and you see a film strip icon. From the pop-up menu, select either Replace from Start or Replace from End. This way, Final Cut Pro ripple trims your clip to the same length as your placeholder clip. For this first clip, let's ripple trim the start of it to the start of our project and the end to the first red marker. Delete the placeholder clips above it. Grab your second clip and drag it into your timeline to replace the next placeholder clip. Once again, select either Replace from Start or Replace from End. Keep doing this to replace every placeholder clip. If you want your video clip to last longer than one beat, simply ripple trim it to the length you want and delete the placeholder clips above it. Just make sure all your cuts are lined up with the markers. Once you're done, the cuts in your project will line up perfectly with the beats in your music for a much more pleasant viewing experience. Besides cutting your video to music, Beat Mark 2 is also very handy if you need to change the duration of your song. You blade your clip right on the markers and either delete or duplicate parts of your song to make it shorter or longer. Cutting the clip on similar beats will make your cuts virtually inaudible to the listener. Now for the giveaway. To enter to win one of the 5 free licenses, all you have to do is comment on this video. I'll post a YouTube story in a couple days and randomly pick 5 winners. Make sure you subscribe to my channel to see my story. If you don't win, you can buy Beat Mark 2 for around $10 from Altimedia's website, which I'll have linked in the description below. If you edit your videos to music, trust me, this will be $10 well spent. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, let me know by hitting the like button. If you're new here, make sure to check out the rest of my channel for more tutorials. New videos uploaded every week. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.